Around 70 years ago, there was this guy whose name was Melvin. Melvin Burkhardt, to be exact, and he toured all over the USA. The North, the South, basically anywhere that a man could go. And he was famous for performing one particular thing. And everywhere he performed this thing, the reaction was visceral. You see, Melvin was a sideshow performer. And if you don't know about the sideshow, it's pretty much like magic. Except, it's also exactly the opposite of magic. You see, in magic, you see things that look like they are real, but you know that they aren't. In sideshow, you see things that look like they cannot be real, but the truth is that they are. And the thing that Melvin was famous for, he was one of these, a solid 6-inch steel neck. It's important we have this examined. Please, would you check it out? Make sure it doesn't fold or bend or anything like that. It is absolutely solid. And let's pass it back. Thank you. Would you check it too? Make sure it's solid. It doesn't fold or bend. It's made of steel and it is 6 inches long. Don't look at him. Just examine it yourself. Now the second thing, he looks proud and you're laughing. I don't want to know. So we have a solid nail and we also have an 8-ounce hammer. You see, Melvin's thing was to take a solid 6-inch nail like this and hammer it into one's face via the nose. I mean, we don't have to. Unless you really want to, and you want to, right? You just want to be here the night this thing goes wrong. What a story that would be. Watch close. Ah, there it is, halfway into the nose. Solid sticks. Hey, the only rule of this is if I'm going to do it, you're going to watch. No, you're covering your ears, it's like you don't know how your head works. I don't want to see this! Don't make me watch! Let's see if we can go the rest of the way. Oh, I've got to be careful here, I don't miss and hurt myself. There it is, all the way in. Now, I do not know where you are from, but most of you will be from America. Where I am from, in England, if a man hammers a nail into his face, usually everybody claps. Clap, you're just sat there smiling because you're thinking 6 inches, right? Now there is a problem, there is a nail in my face. This is no way to perform a show. At this point I need some help, and it is always from the person who reacts the most, the worst when it goes in my face. What's your name?
Landy.
Landy, would you please reach up and grab this nail? It's okay, you can stay sitting down. You're not going to have to put your foot against my chest or anything. Just go. Could reach up slow, though. You're really shaking and it's making me nervous. Let's take a deep breath. It's going to be fine. Just reach up, grab the end. Happy Valentine's Day. And then, no, don't pull fast.
I don't
want
to play fruit.
No, that's good. Here we go. Wow, this is a great chat-up line, by the way. Just reach up and grab the end, but don't pull. Careful! Oh, it's going to feel a lot. Here we go. Game face. All right, reach up now. Pull very slowly. Very slower than that. Okay, keep going, keep going. Okay, wait, stop. Start again. That was fun. That's good, right? Here we go. Come on, man. Okay, well, all the way. Ladies and gentlemen, give Landy a hand. Oh. That was gross. You should see how I clean this thing. Listen, I'll take that from the women, but men, you do it in traffic. I know. I'm thinking, how hot was that, right? There's a good way to tell. It's called a meat thermometer. Now you've all worked it out, let's do this thing. You're in the brace position. This is not an aircraft, though, right? Can you take my temperature? So, the best thing is, this one wiggles. Look at that. Look at that. I'm practically a hipster right now. This could be a fashion statement. Those of you who aren't freaked out have probably walked down Hollywood Boulevard at night, right? I know what I mean. Here we go. Four. And we call that the human blockhead.